Where the Lovelight sisters grew up, and their cousin Cordelia lives right next door in her very own playhouse. Cello the eldest and Viola the youngest still live here together.
Good morning, Cello.
Good morning, Viola.
Now I'm shining in their window and seeing them have their morning tea. Viola is getting ready for work at the Montague Reporter. And Cella is caught up in her picture books again, even though she does need to get ready for the Ladies Club tea party they are hosting this afternoon.
Thank you. Luciana, there's your friend's catalog email to him. On a whim, he flirted with him. Okay, take off and let it begin. Hearing little songs, little bird songs. Hearing little words, little words. Loving little songs, little bird songs. Loving little worlds, little worlds. Unfolding words I used to compose to show those little birds where you go. On a hole, in a hole, my heart is so cold. The blood in my veins.
W will seal you in a trash bag.
Ooh, that would be terrible. But I would save myself with the gift that the rose tree gave me.
Thank you.
good. How are you?
Good. Hello. Nice to see you all.
Second Street Bakery on 4th Street, Holly. Cordelia never came to pick up the cake for the ladies' club tea party today.
What's that you say? Oh dear, the cake. Then I'm on my way.
Oh, that's a drop of maple sap. How fine a hostess you are. And to stay in this palace is an honor fit for the Queen of Fairies. You rescued me, and now I am your humble servant forever.
Oh, I won't hold you to that. But it's a wish come true to have you be my friend.
This party's not the same without Cordelia. And it's not the same without the cake. And Alta sent this note with this tape, saying that she couldn't make it today.
Oh, Alta. I hope she doesn't miss out on all the fun because she's so shy.
My head hurts, she said, unable to take the call. But really what she wants is to stay home, to see her friends and neighbors dancing in aqueous halls. Seeing through all the signs.
Fauna B. I must search for her, because I know she would do the same for me. But if I leave the pointer, I will surely be spotted, or swatted, and I have no idea at all where she would be.
Out of here. We have to get back to the planters where we're safe.
Oh, we're not safe there. I was poisoned with pesticides. And look at this.
What's wrong with purple petunia?
They want to dig up everything else.
You're telling me our whole world is coming to an end, and you're dancing with a doll?
It's just a proposal. The town meeting about it is tomorrow, and I'm forming a plan. Dancing helps me focus.
The party is in full swing next door. What a day for fainting fairies.
What's happening?
She's taking this quite well.
Hitty and Fauna were only going to peek in the window. And then we're going to the theater.
Flora!
She hasn't quite got your spunk, has she, Fauna?
Well, I showed her the article, and of course that came as a shock.
Oh, of course!
Well, I really must do something.
Oh, that frissy, petulant, pretty... Please! Perhaps I can use my influence this town to do something about this.
What are you going to do?
I'm going back to that tea party.
Hey.
everyone. Please excuse me for arriving so late, but while I have your attention, I have an announcement to make. I am forming a horticultural society to take charge of the town planters and preserve them from a plate of purple petunias, for which I happen to be allergic. All new members, please sign here, and you will be swept up in the summer of gardening and galas and many blisses of botany. Side by side, we tenderly tend the roses, zinnias, ranunculus, and lilies, and ever-blooming variety of posies that will be lost from downtown forever. This ranunculus monocrop mania is allowed to take over. Thank you.
Captures my mood.